this was like in elementary school. So I can say my first favorite rap group was Wu-Tang. When I got into middle school, that's when I started to experiment more with like other music. And my spirit was just like connected to it. Like it just felt right. I definitely use like elements of punk, like the aggressiveness and just kind of that, kind of like standing up for yourself sort of thing in my work. I just don't like to sort of put women into this category where they're supposed to be like graceful, that, you know, you have to be a lady, no cussing and things like that. And so for me in my head, it's like not all of us grew up that way, you know. Some of us really are just bitches and we know how to own it, you know what I mean? This aspect of being like a woman in kind of a community where you're sort of forced to be to kind of toughen up and have like thick skin. So there's definitely an element of that. A trend I noticed lately is there's always these kind of women, like Instagram models, sort of painted now. But back then, when you look at classical artworks and like works from the masters, you have like women that are just like they're wrinkly and like they're just natural, you know. And I just feel like I see the same type of woman, you know. And especially from like a female perspective, there's kind of this like, let's take for example the symbol of mermaid, you know. And I think in like our culture and Latino culture, like a lot of the girls want to relate to La Sirena, and I don't relate to that. Like I know the story of the siren, you know what I mean, and it's ugly, like, you know. And so I like to kind of be the opposite from that, or I like to sort of represent a woman that's like not part of the norm. And so that's why I have like pieces like Never Been a Mermaid, or it's like this kind of not ugly but just like this weird octopus head girl, but like she feels good, or like you know what I mean, and like she's aggressive or whatever. And but it also kind of taps into like my own personal life, because I grew up angry, I grew up that way. And so you know. And he was also, he had a bad temper. Like my dad was just a really scary person. So I think it was just as a child I just learned that, you know, because he knew how to instill fear in people. And so I just learned that, but I didn't want to be that person. I think it's just because I didn't see him, it was okay, you know, to be that way. That like that's left me. I don't, and I was raised by my mom and my grandmother most of my life, so that kind of, that softened me up, you know. But I think also it made me stronger, because like I think I grew up with women who went through a lot. Like they went through a lot. My mom went through a lot with my dad, because he was also abusive. He was also abusive, and so that was that just left me like angry for a long time. Find like the humorous side of it, I guess. And so then I up, bottled up, you know, and I mean, I wasn't doing that. That just made stuff worse, you know? And so I'm okay talking about it. There's definitely, I mean, my goal is to do this for life, you know, full time. I could honestly tell you that before this, I was not a happy person. It's like 30 was like kind of a rebirth. And so I'm like really happy doing this. I don't think I'm like the best, but I could definitely get better. But for sure it makes me happy. And it's like when I'm painting, it's like nothing else really exists. Like you're just kind of like everything, like your emotions and your thoughts, it's just going into that painting. And you're not really thinking about anything. Like you're not really about anything or anxious, and that's the kind of person that I am. So it's like that's just the one moment. That's the